For one glorious shining moment, the final problem, which is the final Sherlock episode, at least for a little while, was absolutely perfect. And of course I'm talking about when Moriarty went to visit Sherrinford. Or is that when the Joker went to visit Arkham Asylum? Yes, last night for the final problem, Sherlock went full Batman, and you never go full Batman, unless, of course, you are Batman. Now, I'm sure many of you right now are typing, but Grace, Batman's partially based on Sherlock. They have a lot of crossover, and I can understand not only that that's true, I can appreciate that, but I can also appreciate that the creative team behind the show was like, hey, people love comic books these days, and Sherlock shares a lot of similarities with Batman. Why not go there? But I think they went so far in the direction of Batman that in the process they lost sight of what makes Sherlock unique and original, different from Batman. They are not the same. And I think the chief difference is the solving of the mystery. Batman, sure, he solves a lot of mysteries, but he's only solving them in as far as stopping the crime. Once Batman stops the crime, he's like, okay, on to the next one. Or I'm gonna go hang out at the Batcave and bond with whatever Robin I'm currently with or talk to Alfred. You know, he's got stuff to do. I don't think that he appreciates the game, you know, that famous game that Sherlock relishes so much. And also, with Batman, his enemies often have no motives because they're mad. And speaking of mad villains, I feel that the final problem took an awful lot from The Killing Joke, which again, I can understand the desire to go there. And it works a little bit, but it borrowed so much from The Killing Joke that I felt at one point when he went to see Eros in her cell for the first time before she turned around, I was like, if that's a nurse or a guard in a Eros wig, Alan Moore should hope for a credit at the end of the show, you know, a thank you, because he obviously has inspired this so much. And to the creative team's credit there, I think they did Batman quite well. In fact, if I were Ben Affleck with his upcoming Batman movie, maybe I'd want to reach out to them, or at least use this as an example of modern-day Batman done incredibly well. I thought that Sherrinford made a great Arkham Asylum. I thought that the team-up, a rogues team-up between Moriarty and Eros, at least initially, was a lot of fun. And I also thought that Eros's funhouse maze was classic Batman, right? But there was a sickness to it and a horror that doesn't fit Sherlock's elegant world. That's Batman. And I feel that this crossed a line again where it just no longer became Sherlock. You know, I expect that creepy weirdness in a Batman story. But I don't know. I think with Sherlock, there was a perverseness to it that just didn't work and made me feel a little uncomfortable. There were also three other developments that pushed me into the dislike category for the final problem. Number one, I love having a strong female villain, and I was really excited when Eros was introduced in the last episode. But that Moriarty would film those sound bites for her, I thought was a horrible choice. It made him her pawn, and that really annoyed me. It made me lose respect for Moriarty as a character. He's supposed to be the main villain, or at least Eros' equal. I thought that's what they were setting up when he first came to see her. But the fact that he would be like, oh, do you want just like some, you want me to fill out some, you know, film a little couple of bits for you to use as you please? And the fact that he did means that he never, all of this, you know, the miss me stuff, that was all Eros. You know, that, I don't understand why to bring up a female character, you have to tear down a male character. I had a similar problem in Suicide Squad, the movie, when they were like, oh, you think the Joker is crazy? Well, Harley's even crazier. She's the true mad genius. And you're like, why'd you have to throw Joker under the bus like that? Why can't they both be awesome? So that really frustrated me. It made me like Eros a little bit less, quite frankly. So that was bad. I also really didn't like the Molly scene. And I was reading an interview afterwards that said that they added that at the last minute because nobody liked the scene that they had, you know, that Moffat and Gaddis had put in there first. But I really hated what they came up with because I think it promotes an idea that is very destructive. And so nobody should encourage it. And that's that even if someone acts like they don't like you, like if your crush is like, I'm sorry, I just don't like you, you should not encourage people to think that deep down they really do. Sherlock doesn't like Molly. And I hope that the scene when he got so upset afterwards is that he didn't like doing that to her. He's like, why do you make me lead Molly on? I don't like her. It's so cruel. But I felt like the way they had him say I love you and that it was difficult for him to say it. And when I read the interview again between Moffat and Gaddis about this scene, they seem to be saying that Sherlock maybe did like Molly. And I'm like, you know, it's been four seasons. He's never made an effort to talk to her, to spend any time with her, even in a friendly capacity. But he does text Irene Adler late at night. So don't tell me that he has any romantic feelings for Molly. I thought that was really bad. I thought that that scene was as cruel from Moffat and Gaddis' perspective as it was from Eurosis. I really did not like that it was in there. I do not like this idea that Sherlock deep down likes Molly. He doesn't. He likes Irene Adler if he likes anyone at all. All right, maybe he likes, I think he likes Watson better than Molly. So I really resented that scene being included. And then finally, I think that they made Euros unforgivable. So it was very frustrating to me that Sherlock was able to forgive her. I know that she's his sister, but she did just such horrible things. She drowned a little boy who did nothing. It's not like this was a mean little boy who tormented her. He was totally innocent, right? The only thing he was guilty of was that Sherlock enjoyed playing with him more than Euros, right? Like if she'd killed Watson, would he be like, hey, you know what, hey, this stuff happens. Maybe I should have paid more attention to you. I mean, that's horrible. She also shot Art Malik's wife. Oh, and I was so nice to see Art Malik. I love Art Malik. I like that he was there. And then she killed Watson's psychiatrist, the person who was, she was posing, you know, Watson never met her, but she killed that woman. And who knows how many other innocent people she killed in trying to put her, in putting her plan into motion. So the fact that Sherlock would be like, let's have a violin duet. I'd be like, you know, I know that there, again, going back to the Batman thing, the Batman and the Joker have like some common ground, but that's because of Batman. But what Alan Moore is really saying there is that Batman's a little bit crazy himself, right? To put on a bat costume and this is what he does with his life. There's a commonality there. But Sherlock, they made quite an effort in this episode to show, we'll talk about this, that he was a good man. So how could a good man have someone like that in his life? I mean, I think that at a certain point, you know, again, you might be like, well, it's because he's so good. But at a certain point, it's just, it's such a betrayal of the people who were murdered. I could see him going to visit her, but there seemed to be no, I think he should go visit her, but be kind of like, you're evil and I should, you know, be careful around you. But instead he was like, oh, we're back, we're reunited as a family, how great. And I'm like, why don't you go tell that to the family of Redbeard, see how they feel about it. I think they're not going to think it's such a cute family portrait. All right. I also did not appreciate that the plane was a cop-out. I suspected that it was a stage situation. You know, they had some kind of sound stage and they built a plane in there and they weren't really flying, especially after he woke up hours later and the plane was still in the air. But the fact that it was in Euros' mind, not fair, because that's totally, nobody in the audience could deduce that. And I think Sherlock, in a way, didn't deduce it either until he, you know, went to the room and there she was. But Sherlock's stories are supposed to, you know, it was a cheat by the writers. A good mystery, you can see how it's solvable. And that was what was so great about last week's episode, you know, episode 2 in season 4 with Culverton Smith. But this was just like, it was the writers trying to be cleverer than you. They're like, oh, guess what? It was all in Euros' mind. I bet you didn't see that coming. And you're like, I didn't see it coming because you just freaking made it up. I use this all the time as a metaphor, as an analogy. And it's like when you're playing tag with like a little kid and you get the other person and they go, oh, you didn't get me. I had an invulnerability shield up. And you're like, where did we get invulnerability shields? That was not, you know, mentioned in the rules. And it's just like someone just making something up to, you know, keep going. And I don't appreciate that. I also felt that deciphering the song via the, I like that Nemo was, you know, no one. I like that clue. I thought that was good. Although it was very similar though to who do you kill? Anyone, you know, that being one word that's a name. So I was like, is that a callback? You guys already used that, right? But then with the dates on the tombstones used to number the words in the song and then rearranging them, that was also incredibly far-fetched. You were like, you know, come on, are you kidding me? I would be very upset with Euros. I'd be like, your puzzles are ridiculous, Euros, okay? And I also wasn't too pleased when Mary showed up at the end either. You know, like, I miss you. And I'm like, Mary, you're so goddamn annoying. Like, she just had to put her stamp on things and claim ownership yet again. Like, I might be dead, but my ghost hangs over this whole show. Like, she had to call them my Baker Street Boys. I'm like, they're not your Baker Street Boys. They're the world's Baker Street Boys. What the hell? But I did love Sherlock as a pirate. I thought that was a great line. It reminded me actually of The Martian when, you know, Mark Watney, a space pirate. I also liked Mycroft in disguise. I love the opening scene in Mycroft's house when they spooked him, they tricked him. That was like classic Sherlock. I thought that was great. And I liked the ending, you know, when them talking about that Sherlock and Watson would always go on. And that last shot when they froze them was just beautiful because it was just... It perfectly captured the characters. And I had in my notes here that it was, they looked brilliant, they looked dashing, they looked elegant, they looked very British, which I thought was great because, you know, Sherlock represents the UK. And also they seemed so good. And again, I love that line about clarifying that there is a difference and a distinction between a great man and a good man is a better thing to be. I thought that was really wonderful. I loved that. I think, to be honest, that it's difficult to come up with mysteries, really good mysteries like the Culverton Smith one, and that I think that Moffat and Gaddis just need a break. And so I hope, while I would love to see Sherlock and Watson return, and the door has definitely been left open with for that, intentionally so, take a couple of years. You know, let Cumberbatch and Freeman pursue their career opportunities that are plentiful right now, and then come back, like I'd say, maybe in a couple of years to do, or even sooner. But make sure you have that great episode. Make sure you have a great script. Don't come back just to come back, because I think that the show has slipped a little bit too far into fan service. You know, like the kiss between Sherlock and Moriarty was totally for the fans. And I think the stuff with Molly was for the fans. And also the scene here when they're like, this is for family, Sherlock. And Sherlock's like, that's exactly why Watson stays, because he's family. I felt that was for like the Watson-Sherlock shippers. You know, like I feel like the show is just trying to give the fans what they want instead of a beautifully constructed episode. So come back, but only when you guys are ready, all right? And also, they never should have killed off Moriarty. I know that he dies in the books originally, but I think he died too soon on this show, and I think that it was a fatal flaw, in fact, for the show. And a lot of the show, even past his death, has been people like, he's coming back. And I was so elated when he did, and then they were like, oh, 5 years ago, ha ha. And I think that trying to substitute Euros for Moriarty just doesn't work. Euros should have been her own thing, not like, oh, it was Euros all along. I didn't like that. And I think they killed Moriarty off way too early, and I think that will always haunt the show, and it'll always be a problem for it, and people will always want him to come back. But now I don't know how they're going to be able to do that. I don't know. It's a shame. But anyway, I was disappointed in this episode. I think that Moffat and Gaddis pushed themselves too far, further than they were ready, but it's a great formula, it's a great team, and sometimes the show is brilliant, so I think it should be remembered for when it was, even though it didn't end on the best note. So I'm curious, I know this episode has divided fans. For those of you who liked it, what did you like about it? For those of you who didn't enjoy it as much, like myself, what were your problems with it? And what do you think of the Batman-Sherlock comparison? Do you think they went full Batman, and do you think that was a mistake? Or you like Grace, that was the best part of it. Write your thoughts down below. Thank you for watching this season with me, and you can check out some other episodes right now.